Oh, that's better. I have a much better frame rate now.
Forgot to put my glasses on. Should have done that a while ago. This is gonna be weird. Let's bring up the race brief. That is not what I wanted to do.
Spicy chili.
There we go. I think it's better. Yes. To the weather? There is a link to the weather. Looks like no rain is expected over the next 3 hours. So, we'll see. We'll see how it goes.
Thank you, Ross. Right, everyone, if you would escape to the pit, please. Just head on back and get yourself in there if you're not already there. See a couple drivers still out on track waiting to do that. Be very kind if you would do it now. Instead of finishing your lap.
Cop, Ben, cough.
Okay, thank you, everyone's in the pit. So, welcome everybody to the next race in the P-Cup series. It's great to have, we got 29, almost 30 drivers out here. Absolutely fabulous, and I'm really thankful for all the support you guys are bringing to the race series here. It's just great. So I'm going to go through the brief pretty quickly. I think everyone's had a chance to read it. You should have had a chance to read it by now and get everything sorted out. And really, a lot of this has been pretty bog standard for all the series. A lot of the stuff we do all the time. I would like to highlight just one thing. Folks do know or should have seen the penalty announcements by the stewards this week for some of the activities last week. And one in particular, just we had a discussion amongst the stewards and the admins on the issue of track cuts. And as I've been mentioning all the way through this series, is that while rF2 does enforce track cuts, some of the tracks are better at doing this than others, and Nürburgring is pretty good. That in no way, shape, or form denies drivers the opportunity to submit an IRR on people they think are exceeding track limits on a regular basis and doing so to gain advantage whether or not they get hit with a cut by RF2, because they have no way of knowing. You do have that, that we do police ourselves for good racing behavior in terms of staying on the track and using it properly. So regardless of the track, you can submit IRs and you can be penalized by the stewards for repeated behavior that is not within the general competition rules. So just in case you were wondering about that, it's the RF2 is not the be-all end-all for track cuts. As with everything else that you do on track, it is subject to an IRR if it doesn't conform to the general competition rules. That out of the way, we're up for a great race tonight at the Nurburgring GP. And as always, it is 60 minutes of race time. There are 4 minutes to get around the course tonight, so whoever's on the front row, take your time. You've got 4 minutes to get around the track.
20 minutes remaining. You've got 20 minutes left.
Start-finish line to cross and give ourselves 60 minutes of racing, not 62 or 63 or 59, but 60, please. And as usual, we have a 15-minute qualifying session where everyone's out on track, so just pay attention to each other. If you do use escape to get back into the pits and come back out again, pay attention to the people coming through on the flying lap. Give them the priority to come through on T1 and make sure you stay out of the way as you're doing your outlap for anyone else that's coming through. As you saw, we're on live weather, and so that should make it entertaining. And the start is as we always are, which is a standing start from the grid, and head off in pairs as you start. If there's tight places, there are a couple, three places where it's a little bit tight, you can certainly relax. The pairs go zipper through some of the chicanes and things like that. Certainly the last chicane would be a place we'd want to do that. And then get yourself back up into 2x2 as you know, relatively quickly, so that we don't get too strung out and make it really hard for the back markers to get into formation for the start. So as we come around the final corners, the pace should be relatively slow for the front two to let the rest get closed up, and then we're off. It's race starts at the start line for each pair, no passing prior. And I've really been impressed with what I've seen out of the Orange Zone reviews for this series. People are really doing a pretty good job of that. Remember, on the pace lap, there's no weaving or hard acceleration or braking. You can drag your brakes to warm them up, but keep a constant speed and keep it nice and regular so we all get to the start line in good order. Today's Orange Zone is from the start finish to T8. And, you know, as usual, it's racing is racing. However, if you get a penalty in that area from stewards, it is going to be more severe, because we do want to keep that first bit good and ruin no one's race. You are responsible for knowing if you have steward assigned penalties, and they have to be served as required in the GCR. Make sure that if you're if you've got one that requires you to stop or hold, you do it behind the pace car off the pit lane and manually count the time you must be stationary. Any of the RF2 assigned penalties during race are served normally, either a drive through or if you have a wait of some period, do it in your pit box so you clear it out. I think everyone's clear on the blue flag as per the CMS GCR. Blue flag drivers don't have to get out of the way, but don't compete or whether obstruct the lapping car. The lapping car is responsible for making a clean pass, and everyone's got the responsibility for being respectful for each other in the race. We talked about track limits. Make sure one wheel on the racing surface, which is on the white line or inside the track. Everyone, I think, is pretty clear on turn one, turn three, four, and the chicane at 14:15, and the area for the pit entry lane directly after. Just make sure you're signaling your intent really clearly there. On pit entry, make sure you are well right and enter at the beginning of the entry lane. Don't cross the pit lane line. Use the fast lane to get to your pit box, and then, you know, drop into your pit box, do whatever you have to do, and then the same thing on the way out, get back into the fast lane as quickly as possible, and then move your way through on the exit all the way down to the end of the pit lane exit. You can't move on to the racing line until then. And make sure that you're watching out for hot lapping traffic, and the same thing for the hot lappers coming through. And you know, talking about that pit lane, you are eligible for an IR by other drivers if you are coming out of the lane cross it in front of them or behind them. And the same thing for people diving down to the pit lane exit or entry for whatever reason while there's traffic in there going in or out of the pit. You can be IR'd for that. There's no requirement for pitting today, but it's up to you as you wish to. Case of an incident, apply the golden rule, return the position that you caused someone to lose by just slowing down in a safe place, let them get by you and get back in again. We're not scheduled for darkness, but it's always a good rule to have your lights mapped properly, either auto or you know where it is, so you can turn them on if you need to. And I think everyone's clear on what escape means in a race. You're done. So it's either control, alt, delete, or unplug your network cable, come back in, and yeah, you'll be down laps, but you can still race for points. And we will do a pit box check at the end of at the start of the warm-up. And so when you come out of your when you come click drive, request a pit right away and see if you can drive.
Okay, Eric, 15 minutes left. That's 15 minutes.
Make sure you center your car on the right line of the outline, so that the other person, of the right line of the right pit crew, so that the other person can pull in beside you if they have to. And a last point that I did not mention, it's on the pace lap. If you stall or have an aft track or otherwise lose your place during the formation lap, you have to let the field carry on and join the back. Okay, don't try and force your way into your original position. It's your bad luck, but we're not going to mess up the start for it. And the gap created must be maintained by the driver, so no moving up. Any questions? Great.
Thank you, Matt.
Thank you. All right, guys. I think we're squared away then, and I should be able to move us forward in the session to the next session. And we're into the qualification, or quali, or qualifying, as some people would like to say. Remember, it's mic off for both Q and the race, except for urgent safety issues. Everyone have a great race and good luck in quali.
That's the end of the session. P7.
Thank you, Matthew.
Ross isn't even driving tonight. All right, let's see if we can get a good qualifying lap. The dry line is at 0% wet. The off the dry line is very, very wet. Please don't hit me.
Clear, push now. Okay, Eric, we've got 14 minutes to set a lap. Your brakes are cold, take it easy. Yellow flag.
All right, here we go. Paul Ibbotson is ahead of me. He is probably about my speed, so I don't think I'll catch
him. The track temperature is increasing. It's now 57 Fahrenheit. Close to Ibby, so I'll back off. Nobody's behind me. At least not meaningfully.
go.
Green flag sector one.
Let's see what we can do.
Incident in sector two. Sector two is yellow. It looks like Fass has crashed in turn six. Green flag in sector two.
All right, 2012 is the estimated right now. Nope, nope, nope. Those tires
are killed. Sector two, yellow flag.
Coming out of
the
heavy
leader has just done a 159.3 as a car approaching across the white line.
God.
Green flag, sector two. Blue flag, I think P4's gone off. Flag.
Car on your right, all clear on the right.
Incident in sector one, yellow flag. All right, Eric, 10 minutes to go. That's 10 minutes left. Green flag, sector one.
So I have to cut at least one lap.
There's a faster car approaching. The guy behind has just done a 201.2. Yellow flag.
Okay, let's see what we can do.
P12.
That's because I haven't turned a lap yet, so I'm dead last. Definitely too. Oh god.
Sector one, yellow flag. Green flag in sector one.
Really? Whew. Close. Five is the estimated. Let's see if we can keep it.
Yellow flag, sector two. guy behind has just done a 203.2. Your brake temperatures are okay. Sector 1 is yellow.
Oh god, terrible.
The leader's just done a 159.3. Think that FAS has gone off in turn 7. Green flag, sector 2. Sector 1 is 0.6, off the pace. Yellow flag.
Faster
okay,
still.
Eric, 5 minutes to go, 5 minutes left. Your best lap in this session.
Ugh, eighth.
Sector 3 is 2/10 off the pace. The guy behind has just done a 200.9.
Come on, quality pace. Find it.
We've got 10 minutes of fuel remaining.
Nope. Oh!
Track's clear. Push, push, push. Sector 1 is now green. We need to get some heat into these brakes. Sector 2 is clear. 2 minutes to go. 2 minutes.
Okay, I'll get one more of that.
Sector 2 is now yellow. Yellow flag, sector 1. Alright Eric, there's a faster car approaching. The leader has just done a 159.1. Sector 3 is clear, green flag. We think that FAS has stacked it in. Turn 1, sector 1 is clear. 10th position. Sector 1 is 0.9 off the pace.
Are you fucking kidding me with the rain?
That's the end of the session, P10.
.004 Ninth place, you kidding me? Oh, what was the... Oh my god, 203. 2000. Mac ran a 59.8. Jeez. Not my day.
Well, sun certainly does make a bit of a difference. Some great runs out there. Daniel just crushing it at 157.54 to take the overall lead and the top of the pros. Wayne Galvin coming in not so far behind to take the Pro-Ams with his last lap over Ben. And Oliver Day showing some great turn of speed to take the top of the AMs and a fair bit ahead of the closest competitor. So well done, guys. We'll be flipping over to the warm-up in a second. Remember, we're going to go just immediately ask for a pit and go into the pit.
Okay, pit stop requested. is ready.
Okay, how's everybody doing?
Doing good.
Not out yet. Hold on.
Hey, Tommy, are you in your stall next to me, or are you behind me?
Yes, I'm in my stall. I think it's slightly behind. Out of reverse.
Yeah, how are we doing? Just see a fair amount of people out. Just waiting for everyone to get lined up. Are you out yet, Gilles?
Yeah, just got reverse. And I'm in my stall, and I actually looked in my rear left quarter to see if there was somebody, and I saw some piece of wall in the library. Oh, that ain't it working.
Okay. Don't forget, you can always choose a different camera angle, everybody, just to look around you to see what's going on.
My stall, John, it's right behind you.
Oh, excellent. Look at that. It's starting to rain again. Woohoo!
Okay.
All right. If everyone's had their opportunity to check their stall and they're happy, you are free to go. You got about 8 minutes left. If you haven't done a pit stop yet, just check the entries so you know what you're looking at.
So my force feedback is dying. It just suddenly feels like I'm down to treacle. Does anyone know how I can fix that?
Have you got your force feedback mapped?
Your exit looks clear. Stay behind the line. Yellow flag.
No, I mean, the button
looks like
maps
V6
on the
has gone
keyboard.
Off. Green flag in sector one. You've got cold brakes all round.
You can reset it. What they're saying, you can map
okay,
it.
Okay, I'll
reset
it.
I think tilde is the default key.
Up in the corner and then check assign buttons, and you can assign a button for force feedback.
Mine was doing that too. I just had to hit my reset button.
Yeah, mine did that.
I can't find it.
On your left. You're clear left.
Found it, Emma.
Any helmet?
Yellow flag in sector 3. Looks like P4 has gone off in turn 15. Green flag in sector 3. Sector 1, yellow flag. Okay, Eric, there's a car exit in the pits. Heads up.
Yeah, it's not fixed it.
It's not fixed it by remapping it.
Does it show on the screen reset?
Yeah, it came up reset. Okay, right.
Yeah, maybe just try to turn your wheel off and on or something.
Yeah, you might have to jump out and go back in again. Your wheel reset with your wheel back.
Yeah,
on.
Yellow flag, sector 2.
Don't turn it off in game, you'll just crash again.
Looks like P2's yeah, got off in. Turn 7.
5 minutes, just exit the game and turn off your wheel, reset it, come back in.
Reboot!
That was a great TV show, by the way.
Yes.
No, second race in a row that we've had some rain.
5 minutes remaining, 5 minutes left.
100% of the races have had rain.
Oh, really?
Yep. Côte d'Azur, the first race, the last race.
I've only made two, so...
I've only had rain.
Well, we went to Africa, right?
It did, I think, at some point. Maybe it didn't.
That lap was a 202.2. Green flag in sector 2.
Too early through that last corner, not getting a great exit.
Yellow flag, keep your wits about you, mate. Your quickest overall. I think P4's gone off in turn 6. Sector 2 is clear.
I don't think we break at the same plane, Eugene.
Nope. I'm later, I guess.
Interesting.
Sector 2 time is
slower
okay.
Slower mile an hour through that last corner, but faster sector time.
Just 2 minutes left, 2 minutes to go. P3. Sector 3 is 0.3 off the pace.
All right, the race is coming up.
Track temperature's rising. It's now 83 Fahrenheit. The leader has just done a 2.00.1 seconds.
Yeah, still a bit weird. It's not, I don't know, don't explain it. I've also changed pit stall apparently, so if anyone was at the very end, I might be sharing with them now.
Yeah, that happens when you go out and come back in again.
So I guess we're not sharing anymore.
No, I'm sorry we're not.
Until you do your first stop, never expect it to be where it was in warm-up.
Checker flags out, P5.
Okie dokie.
Just in case.
We are getting ready for the race.
think I have enough fuel. We'll
Mike, were you going to be joining us? I saw you left.
No, man. My performance is atrocious tonight.
Oh, that's no good. Sorry to hear that.
Yeah, maybe next time.
Well, at least there's a broadcast.
That's the end of the session. P5. The track temp is 48. The air temp is 48 Fahrenheit. 60 minutes.
Okay, guys. Got time to get set up. Make sure your setup's all in and ready to go.
If you get on the grid, I assume you can't escape.
You can up until the horn sounds and the race begins.
Okay.
It asks you if you want to quit.
At
least it's still raining. I was worried it might have gone dry.
And nothing but blue skies
over me. Okay, guys, remember just to roll off nice and easy. Take it doubles through the whole pace lap.
Let's go.
The idea is to get us back to the start-finish line.
Yellow flag, copy that. No tire change at the next stop.
Just gets worse and worse, mate. This drive-through, I've just got...
Careful, car on your left. Hold your line. Right. Clear on the left side.
Yeah,
green flag, sector one.
Yes. Yes.
Car on your left. All clear on the left. Clear left.
Okay, Eric. Decent start. We can build something from here.
Spot off.
Didn't understand that.
Don't spot.
On your left. Easy, hold your line.
No, I didn't catch that.
Clear left.
What time is it?
I didn't catch that.
What time is it?
Careful, car on your left.
I didn't catch that.
Looks like careful, my voice commands are not working.
Still there. Still there. Clear left.
Yeah, no voice commands for me with the crew chief. Gotta do it on the manual.
Left side.
Hold your line. Order me a pizza.
Hold your line.
Take delivery in turn 6.
Hold your line. Easy, hold your line. Still there. All clear on the left.
I'm pretty sure I'm supposed to be next to Norm, and he's not supposed to be next to Eugene, but nobody ever seems to figure out the right zipper in this series.
Car on your left. Hold your line. Careful, still there. Still there. You're clear left.
Alright, we are going to pick up 100 places.
Clear on the left side.
No, maybe we'll pick up 2 places at the beginning.
Easy, car on your left. Careful, still there. Hold your line. Hold your line.
Good luck tonight, guys.
Easy. Hold your line.
There. Remember the chicane just
still there.
Way through, and then nicely paired up.
Still there.
And make it to the finish line.
Still there. Careful. Still there. Clear left. Car on your left. Hold your line. Easy. Hold your line. All clear on the left.
Yellow flag. Green flag, sector 3.
terrible start. That's okay.
Car on your left. Clear left. Left side. Clear on the left side. Left side. You're clear left.
Sector 1 is yellow.
Oh boy. Everybody wants to stop early when they got a full tank of fuel. So hard to figure out where to brake when I'm like behind everybody like this.
Car on your right.
Oh, really?
Hold your line. Still there. Clear right.
Okay, Eric. You had some minor aero damage. Stay out. It's not that bad. We think Vertelli has spun off. Sector 1 is now green.
Oh, great. And I got
Vertelli
shortcut points.
Just retired.
Lovely.
Gap to graph ahead is now 1.3 seconds.
Early, oh God.
Okay, Eric, don't think about the lap times. Just hit each and every apex. P8.
Good advice.
Sector 1 is yellow.
Doing so good through there, and my GPU totally bogs.
Hello, John.
Well, good run. Totally all up on Norm here.
Careful, car on your right. Clear on your right.
I think I hit him.
South.
Gotta be really careful not to beat up the left rear tire because it will get destroyed
here. Okay, Eric, this bastard's holding you up. You've gotta find a way past. Track temperature is increasing. It's now 93 Fahrenheit.
On your left.
Sector 3 is now yellow. Faster car approaching. They're racing us for position. Don't expect any blue flags. Sector 3 is clear. Green flag.
I don't know if that was my fault or his fault.
Maha, it's getting closer. The gap's now 0.8. 10th position.
My best work. That's okay. We'll get him back.
There's a faster class car approaching. Intimidated by this little shit. Make him work for it.
Early.
Mm-hmm. Yellow flag in sector 2. Looks like P5's gone off in turn 6. Green flag in sector 2.
Gosh.
The gap to Maha behind is now 0.8. Just done 202.6.
Not fun. This is work.
Tonk is now in the lead. That lap was at 202.3. Gap to Maha behind is now 0.8.
That was kind of track cutty, but that's okay. Gotta get on the brakes earlier there.
Almost had a run out of there. Still not using the natural rotation of the car. Oh, boogers. That was close.
P10.
Oh, got a run on you, buddy.
He's racing us for position. Don't expect a blue.
Early. Shit. Don't abuse that left rear.
Okay, Eric, it stopped raining. Clear on the left.
Not really sure what just happened to Mac.
In front has increased to 3.2 seconds.
Which gap? Oh, well, I mean, it's kind of a strange way to think about it.
To Maha behind is increasing. It's now 2.3 seconds. Come on, let's put this hard work to good use. E9, you've just done a 202.7.
Okay, so now the tires are starting to get make things interesting.
class is now retired.
Well.
You've just done a 203.6.
Be nice to catch Ebby. We'll see what happens. Not sure if I was crazy fast through there. Seemed like the wrong gear, but somehow super fast.
Maha is closing in. The gap is now 1.2.
So what I'm hoping for is that everybody else will beat up their tires and I'll be able to pull back the time. I didn't need that much of that curve.
flag sector one.
Oh, his tires are screwed up, I can tell.
This fucker's trying to distract you. Don't let him. Okay, Eric, that's half distance. Fuel levels are fine.
Oh, God.
Easy, car on your left. Clear left. Oh.
That was sketchy. And now the guy behind me is catching me.
They're on your right. On your right. All clear on the right. Car on your left. Still there. Clear on the left side.
Okay, Eric. The next car is Maha. There's a group of faster cars bearing down on you.
Oh my gosh, I have never fought this hard to be a back marker.
Car right, clear right. Car on your right. Hold your line. Hold your line.
Oh my god, this is awful.
Clear on your right.
The gap to Maha ahead is increasing. It's now 1.0.
On your right. Careful, still there. Still there. Easy, hold your line. Still there. clear on your right.
Oh, baby.
Yellow flag sector 3. All right, Eric, you've used half your fuel. Find the gap. That was 203.6.
Run, John.
Come on, find a way around. We're losing time.
Best line through there. Jesus. Bummer. Thank you. run.
Car right. All clear on the right.
Okay, Eric. Stay close. Wait for him to make a mistake.
Car on your right. On your right. Clear right.
Oh God. Good run, John.
The gap to Maha ahead is increasing. It's now 0.8. Luck is leading the race. Your lap time was 203.3.
I should be catching Ibby though. I don't understand.
Keep him in your sights, force the mistake.
Oh my God. Terrible, terrible.
Incident in Sector 2, yellow flag. Sector 2 is green.
Come on.
That's 20 minutes to go. Tong is now leading. The gap to Maha in front is now 8.9 seconds. Yellow flag in sector 1.
Excellent, sorry man.
We think Tong has binned it in turn 1. Sector 1 is clear. Sector 2 is yellow. Green flag in Sector 2. Galvin is now leading. Okay, Eric, you're reeling Maha in. The gap is now 8.4. Good consistency. Keep him coming.
Left rear
tire,
so Anderson dead.
It's gone off in turn 15. Green flag in sector 3.
Points. Sorry.
Team minutes left.
Had a break earlier now for that last corner.
The gap to Maha ahead is now 8.6. Thank you.
Careful, car on your left. Clear left.
Incident in Sector 1, yellow flag. Green flag, Sector 1. We think that Struha has gone off in Turn 1. Yellow flag in Sector 2. Green flag, Sector 2. Okay, Eric, you're gaining on the guy in front. The gap is 7.2 seconds. They're slower than us through Turn 3. Sector 3 is yellow.
Oh man. Patience. Patience is the name of the game with this car.
10 minutes remaining. 10 minutes. You're gaining on this guy. The gap's now 2.4 seconds. He's slow through Turn 3. yellow flag. Watch out. We can see Struha has stacked it in turn three. On your left. Sector one is green. Still there. Hold your line. All clear on the left. Behind's increased to 1.8. Yellow flag, sector 2. It looks like Graf has gone off in turn 7. Sector 2 is now green. Right, Eric, 5 minutes to go, 5 minutes left. That lap time was 2:03.5. Lap times are pretty consistent. Got 10 minutes of fuel remaining. Graf has retired from the race.
Okay, that picks up another place for me. Thank you.
Yellow flag, caution. The reactor Maha in front is now 6.4. Eighth place. That's 2 minutes left. 2 minutes. Green flag, sector 2. Pulling away from the guy behind, the gap's now 9.6. That's 5 minutes of fuel left. One more lap to go.
I grew up to be just like some of you guys when you're driving.
Still driving.
Fucking about
you guys are
fucking so young, Angus.
Guys are driving off the net.
Everybody's
coming. Adam, Adam. Good job. Headed to Tommy and Daniel, and then Ben, Micah, and Wayne for the Pro-Am. Oliver Day way out in front for the AMs, and then Daryl and Josh for third. Interesting race.